you changed your mind about anything? You still believe that unless we do something about the deficit in the near term, the debt in the near term, we face the possibility of catastrophe because some unexpected thing will come to fore, and we will not have the capacity to deal with it.
I agree with, I think, the majority of people, and it's not just inside the Washington think tank, or this incestuous whatever you call
it. Incestuous amplification.
I agree with Steve Ratner, Obama's car czar. Yeah. I do agree with Richard Haass, president of the CFR. I agree with Jeffrey Sachs, pretty preeminent progressive.
Who all believe
that we have a long-term debt problem, and whether they believe that over the next 2, 3, 4 years we need to obsess over the deficit or not doesn't change the fact that they believe we have a generational problem.
The crucial issue right now is, are we going to keep on cutting spending and derailing this recovery, or are we going to at least try to spend some more, provide the extra stimulus, bad word, but the extra stimulus that this economy needs? Nobody disagrees that if we look at the year 2025, there is going to be a problem about it, how we're going to pay for this government.
That's 12 years from now.
Right.
12 years.
Well, in 2025, it is a problem, but not a really severe problem. It gets worse as we go further because population ages, healthcare costs rise. So there is a long-term problem. The question is not, is there a long-term problem? The question is, do we need, in trying to address the crucial problems we have right now, the crisis we have right now, do we need to include that long-term problem in every discussion? Are we unable to deal with mass unemployment unless we at the same time resolve the question of how we're going to pay for Medicare 10 years, 15 years, 20 years from now?